Lipke's been the center of attention the last couple weeks, winning two in a row, trying for his third this week. 2 weeks ago, defeated Dave Richards, 385-360, and last week, Bruno DeFeo went down to Tim, 404-376. This week, another tough bowler coming in. We'll get to him in just a second, but let me catch you up on a few other things. First, the bonus ball contest today would be worth $80. Maybe someone at home will win $80 plus a new set of bowling balls. And the more important thing here is the triple strike pool now has climbed to $1,350. And I said 2 weeks ago I thought it would go in this ladder championship. I'm still holding to that story. I think it's going to go. Let's introduce the bowlers for this week. Returning again from Londonderry, New Hampshire, Tim Lipke, averaging 129. Has a high single of 214. High triple of 515. Roll-off score is 661. And as I said, he's won two in a row. He's going for his third. His opponent this week, another tough competitor, Mike Morgan from Lynn, Massachusetts. Comes in averaging 122. High single 193. High triple 474. And his roll-off score, he's the number two seed in the roll-off at 694. And he comes in with a record of 15-4. So Timmy's going to have his hands full today. And waiting in the wings next week will be Gary Carrington. One of these three bowlers will be our next qualifier for the Tournament of Champions, number five. We're looking for two more. We'll take a short break. We'll come back. Timmy will get us going in semifinal week.
There is power.
Everyone at Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan in Salem, New Hampshire is very proud and excited to again be a major sponsor of Stars and Strikes. We feel that over the years, you, the bowling enthusiast, have become a very important part of our family at Rockingham. And as such, I promise that we will live up to our pledge that we will provide you the best service you have ever experienced. And if you're purchasing a new or used vehicle, at Rockingham, we pledge that we will beat any bona fide deal on any Toyota, any Dodge, or any Nissan anywhere in New England. So just remember, Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan on Route 97 in Salem, New Hampshire.
Honey, I hear it, and that's all for me.
Nobody can say no to Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios.
With real golden honey and toasty, crunchy O's, they're absolutely irresistible.
Nobody can say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to Honey Nut Cheerios.
Everybody loves this stuff.
Hi, honey.
Hey, how's your checkup?
Fine.
Really?
Yeah, heart's good.
And your cholesterol?
Good. You know, the doctor said the healthy diet is paying off.
See? You better keep eating those Cheerios.
As part of a heart-healthy diet, the FDA says soluble fiber from whole grain oat foods like Cheerios may reduce the risk of heart disease. Cheerios is the only leading ready-to-eat cereal that meets this FDA standard.
I always knew you had a good heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I married you.
I thought you'd marry me because I was good-looking.
The one and only Cheerios.
Candlepin Stars and Strikes is brought to you in part by Coca-Cola Classic. Always the real thing, always Coca-Cola.
Okay, welcome back, and here's where we stand as far as the ladder goes. Of course, 2 weeks ago, Tim Lipke knocked off Dave Richards. He followed it up with a victory over Bruno DeFeo last week. Standing in his way this week is Mike Morgan, and waiting in the wings, number one seed Gary Carrington. Timmy will get us started, trying to make it three in a row, and he would love to make it, of course, four in a row and get in the Tournament of Champions. But he's got two tough competitors. Timmy had a big 404 in the victory last week over Bruno. 1, 8, and 9 for Timmy. Good try by Timmy on the spread eagle plus the 5 pin. And it's a 9 box. three, five, seven, nine, and 10 for Tim. Oh, what an effort, and there it goes. A great shot. My, oh, my. Nothing is safe. He had no playable wood, really, to help him. Cuts the three pin on the right-hand side, clears everything out on the right, and finally nudging the seven. What a great shot by Tim Lipke. First look this week, anyways. Mike Morgan has been with us 19 different occasions. He's 15-4 in the win-loss department. And he'll shoot at the 2, 4, and 7. Piece of wood, as you can see, in a tough position at the front. He's going to have to come up high in the wood and try to turn it and drive it back. Yep. And he matches the 9 put up by Tim. Moving over to lane 31. Today we'll receive a check for $250. The winner moves on with a chance to pick up another $500 or $1,000 next week. Two full in the head pin, left the 2. Pair of 9s for Mike Morgan. Tim now working on the spare in the second. How about the 189 again? Hey, hang on. Good effort there for the spare. Works it out with a 10, 4-8-10. Gives him 32 through 3. Might wanted that head pin to stay up. Gives himself 2, 4, 7 in the 10 pins. See if he can get that wood to move. Oh, converts it for the spare. Uses both wood effectively. Take another look at that one. Drives it straight back. Piece of wood to the right takes out the 10 pin. So Timmy, 2 boxes on lane 31 and 2 spares. A spare for Mike on the 4 horsemen plus the 6, 9, and 10. Take a look. Very nicely done. Actually, the ball stayed in play for the 9 pin. Half Worcester left, just 2 on the spare. Disappointed the crowd, and I'm sure disappointed Mike. Get over there. 40 through 4. Now Tim will fill the spare in the fourth. one of these bowlers trying to make it two more victories in a row to get into the Tournament of Champions. Right now, we have four other qualifiers. That's eight on Tim Spare, gives him 50 through four. I'll get to those in just a second. Two and four pins left for Tim. Pulls it just by the two. In fourth place stands Chris Grimes with 362 for the Tournament of Champions. Third place is Steve Plant at 367. Second place is Chris Sargent at 368. One pin difference there between second and third. And the top seed right now, Paul Berger at 417. Hang on. Four, five, seven, ten. Almost made a spectacular shot. And 10 for Tim, 70 through six. Mike Morgan. Lynn, Massachusetts, married. Wife's name is Kathleen. And he has one child, Michael. Spare up for Mike. Mike works for GE. Does a lot of his bowling at the Metro Bowl. Just a little full on the head pin, scrambles to get five. 3-6-10 with a 4-7 on the left. Trying to split the three and the six. Like a pretty good ball going in, but the results are a little bit surprising. 4-5-7-10, similar shot he just had and left the seven pin. At this time, I don't know if he can see the five pin or not. Definitely have to play the wood and see what happens. No, this time he's gonna leave the 10 pin. Two fine efforts by Tim Lipke, but no mark to show for it. And 79. Take a look at, he plays the wood, snaps the wood off the wall, comes in front of the 10 pin and then comes back across. Was the one he wanted in a second ball. Just splits the one and the two pins and the head pin go down, took out the 10 pin for the 10 box. Oh, a big ball, like Mike Morgan, strike in the seventh. See the replay, it didn't take very long. Oh, that close to a double. And the crowd starts buzzing when you get one strike up there. They get very excited when you throw the double. Remember, $1,350 is in that triple strike pool. Compliments of the New Hampshire Candlepin Bowling Association. Mike has a 7-pin piece of wood out in front. You try to get by the wood or maybe hit the red line, have the ball come off the wall. And he's going to go right at the end of it. Very nicely done. Made a tough shot look very easy. Spare on strike. It's his fourth mark of this game. Three spares and a strike. And that double mark gives Mike Morgan the lead of 6 pins. Oh, Timmy right back. Similar shot he had to make the 10 box. Last box without the 7-pin. And does it very nicely. 99 and a ninth plus the bonus ball. Just sliding by on the right. Seems like he's leaving the four horsemen or something to the left quite often right now. This time the four horsemen, but he has a piece of wood in between the four and the seven. Trying to split the one and the two. Make it two in a row. And his fourth mark of this first game, all spares. Right through the middle. 5 and 120. Mike Morgan now working on spare. He's already at 95 through 8. Not bad for missing the head pin. Head pin was the last pin to go down. Leaves just the two. Piece of wood in front. Three in a row. Spare and a double strike and a double spare now. 114 plus the bonus ball. Morgan will have the lead, but it'll be in single numbers. We get 9 and a 128, an 8-pin advantage for Mike Morgan after one semifinal week. Take a short break. We'll be back. We'll talk a little bit about the bonus ball contest. Don't go away.
As part of a heart-healthy diet, the FDA says soluble fiber from whole grain oat foods like Cheerios may reduce the risk of heart disease. Cheerios is the only leading ready-to-eat cereal that meets this FDA standard.
I always knew you had a good heart. That's why I married you.
I thought you married me because I was good-looking.
The one and only Cheerios.
Candlepin Stars and Strikes is brought to you in part by Tri-State Megabucks. Once again, bringing you the Tri-State Megabucks Tournament of Champions.
Okay, we're going to have $80 at stake at the end of the show. All you have to do is send the postcard in, name, address, and a number from 1 to 10. the number of pins you think the winner will knock down. Mail it to Park Place Lanes, Route 28, Windham, New Hampshire, 03087. Good luck. Mike Morgan, leading by 8. That's one way to assure that you're going to stay leading with throwing balls like that. This is the first time Tim Lipke in the last 2 weeks has been behind after string number one. Mike moving over to lane 31 while Cindy removes a pin that has rolled out in 32. Well, one third of the way. Remember, $1,350 for the triple strike. And, oh my, that close to a double. Everything but the 10 pin, piece of wood rolling back now. Mike's brother, you can probably hear him in the background. Tom Morgan coming off a little knee surgery. Spare in the second. Want to wish Tommy Morgan well after a little knee operation. Hope to see him back on the show real soon. Tim back in the 1-2 pocket. He's going to be looking at the 5 and the 9. Far left for Tim. He kind of put his hands over his eyes, but spare is a spare is a spare, Tim. I don't think he wanted to catch this wood, but turned out to be all right. Came off the left side wall and cleared out the 9. Right through the middle, just 5 on the spare. So he'll drop another one in count to Mike Morgan. Candlepin Stars and Strikes are brought to you in part by Tri-State Megabucks. And now with Mega Cash, choose your dream. Tri-State Megabucks. Becoming a household name with Candlepin Stars and Strikes. Morgan drops 8 on that spare. And it's the 8 and the 10 pins left. Piece of wood out in front and to the left of the 8. Another one in between the 8 and the 10 pins. Looks like you have to play the wood next to the, in front of the 8 and see if you can get something to move. No, just twisted it right back, right by the 8 pin. Not much there to shoot at. But his lead now at 22. And 7. Oh, nice spare. Beautifully done by Mike Morgan in the fourth. Just splits. Watch the head pin go down and take out the 7. Oh, needed that 5 pin. It's one of those shots that I never remember going very often anyways. Once or twice, but difficult. The 5, 6, and 10. Even with the wood, almost got the wood to come off the wall for the five. Ten, looking over to lane 31. Last couple weeks, we had a scorekeeper here helping us this week. Harold Hood from Newmarket, New Hampshire, is my, I'd say my right-hand man, but he's on my left, so it has to be my left-hand man. And he's keeping score on the score sheets. Cindy System on the big scoreboard. Yours truly on the computer. And Doug Brown home relaxing. Spare up in the fourth by Tim Lipke. Really needed that one to keep pace with Mike Morgan. There you see a quick check of the scoreboard. Both working on spares. Take a short break, come back, finish game number two.
Honey, that Cheerios and that all for me.
Nobody can say no to Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios.
With real golden honey and toasty crunchy O's, they're absolutely irresistible.
Nobody can say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to Honey Nut Cheerios.
Everybody loves this stuff.
And up to $2,000 on a mattress and box spring. But because I mean business, my generic queen-size set at $399 comes in plush or firm. My generic $399 set has 20% more coils, weighs 30% more, and has a 20% longer warranty than any Sealy, Simmons, or Serta set at any price. Why? Because mine is made by one of these very same national brands without the expensive label. I mean business.
Candlepin Stars and Strikes is brought to you in part by Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan.
Okay, Mike Morgan trying to protect a 21-pin advantage over Tim Lipke. Timmy trying to make it three wins in a row. Well, he wants the 7 or the 10, but neither of them are going to fall. Decent 8 fill on the spare. Three pieces of wood next to the 7 pin. He needs either the ball or a piece of wood to come over and clear out the 10 pin. Let's see if he can make it happen. No. Now it's a 75 half in this second game, opened with a 128. The 2 and the 4 and was just too heavy in the 2, drove it straight back, never touched the 4. Try to get the 4 right now for the 10 bucks. How's that car running of yours in the market for new used cars? Once you travel down to Salem, Route 97, Rockingham, Toyota, Dodge, Nissan. Emmett Horgan and the guys. Come to Salem and save. Rockingham, Toyota, Dodge, Nissan. Tim drops 7 on that spare. 2, 4, and 7 left. Trying to make it 2 in a row and chip away at that lead. Oh my, how did the 7 pin stay up? Him 61, lead 22 for Mike Morgan. A little bit of a break, but he wants that piece of wood to nestle up against that three pin. Somehow he's going to have to make contact with the three pin, with the wood or the ball. Oh, beautifully done. Come on, give him the spare. He had a couple inches to play with there, and he was put the ball right exactly where he wanted to, catching the wood and the three pin. Took out the two and the seven, but not the four. That close to another spare. $10, 95. We have a little correction to make on Timmy's third box. Should be a $9 instead of a 10. Consecutive boxes without a mark. Chance for Tim Lipke to climb back in. Six, nine, and 10 for Tim. His spare attempt. On the right-hand side of the six and cut it in front of the nine. $79, 24-pin advantage for Mike Morgan. Tim can't seem to take advantage of the open frames by Mike. Six on the right, but also has a seven pin. Oh, has it got enough steam? No. For Tim through eight, 104 for Mike, and as you can see, 24-pin advantage so far. String number two, semifinal week in this championship ladder. Next week, Gary Carrington, the number one seed, comes in, takes on one of these bowlers for the championship and a berth into the tournament of champions. One, two, four, and six pins for Mike. $10, 114 through 9. Both bowlers seem to cool off this last half of this game. boy. Look at this. Misses the head pin, and that's all he's left standing. Don't want to let these breaks slip away. For the spare. No. Actually skipped that ball. Left that ball go a little prematurely. Skipped it. Pulled it to the left. Well, last six frames, no marks. 124 and a 252 for a two-game total. Now, Timmy's the type of bowler, he's not going to wait around forever. He's getting a lot of breaks here by Mike not marking. And a spare in the ninth. He'll cut into that 24-pin advantage. He would have a big fill on another marking, get that lead into single digits. There's the fill. That cuts it to 16. 5 and 8 left. Make it 2 in a row at the end for Tim. And he does. .116 plus this last ball. And we're going to have a match, folks. A .123. And a 243 for a two-game total. The lead is just 9 pins for Mike Morgan. Semifinal week, don't go away. We got a great one working here.
Hi, honey.
Hey, how's your checkup?
Fine.
Really?
Yeah, heart's good.
And your cholesterol?
Good. You know, the doctor said the healthy diet is paying off.
See? You better keep eating those Cheerios.
As part of a heart-healthy diet, the FDA says soluble fiber from whole grain oat foods like Cheerios may reduce the risk of heart disease. Cheerios is the only leading ready-to-eat cereal that meets this FDA standard.
I always knew you had a good heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I married you.
I thought you married me because I was good-looking.
The one and only Cheerios.
Gordon's Army and Navy Store, located in the Northland Mall on Route 108, Newton Road in Plaistow, New Hampshire, has been the area's leading Army and Navy store since 1918. Gordon's Army and Navy Store offers a wide range of products, catering not only to the working person, but to the sports and outdoor enthusiast, with brand names like Carhartt, Lee, LaCrosse, and Fox River. They also excel as the area's largest paintball store. With UPS services and prepaid calling cards, they're referred to by their customers as the store that reputation built.
Honey, out Cheerios, and they're all for me.
Nobody can say no to Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios.
With real golden honey and toasty, crunchy O's, they're absolutely irresistible.
Nobody can say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to Honey Nut Cheerios.
Everybody loves this stuff.
Hi, honey.
Hey, how's your checkup?
Fine.
Really?
Yeah, heart's good.
And your cholesterol?
Good. You know, the doctor said the healthy diet is paying off.
See? You better keep eating those Cheerios.
As part of a heart-healthy diet, the FDA says soluble fiber from whole grain oat foods like Cheerios may reduce the risk of heart disease. Cheerios is the only leading ready-to-eat cereal that meets this FDA standard.
I always knew you had a good heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I married you.
I thought you married me because I was good-looking.
The one and only Cheerios.
Here are the winning numbers from last night's Tri-State Megabucks drawing.
Well, Mike Morgan has won two of the battles, 128-120, 124-123. But he hasn't won the war yet. Jimmy Lipke is still hanging around, just 9 pins behind Mike. Three, six, and then the triangle, 4, 7, 8. Oh, just missed. clipping that three pin. There's one you want to, don't want to miss the three, because if you missed it, if you caught the three pin, you might be able to make that shot on the inside with the wood in front of those other three pins. What you didn't want to do is go to the right. Everything but the nine, but the five, a drop of nine. Spare in the second. That's what you want to do. Trailing, you want to put that first mark up. Give your opponent something to think about. Runner up, $250 today. And the winner, chance to get into the big bucks and the tournament champions by going to the next week's championship week. A little light hit there, and just a four drop, cluster of five in the left-hand corner, plus the 10 pin. Matches the nine put up by Tim, but now he has a spare to face. Light hit again, this time the 5, 7, and 10. See where the wood settles down. That's a real fine shot. Spare in the second. And here's a replay of that shot, the 5, 7, and 10. I'm talking about real things, how about Coca-Cola? One of our prime sponsors of Candlepin Stars and Strikes. Coca-Cola, always the real thing, always Coke. A cola. 8 drop for Tim on the spare. Five, seven left for Tim, trying to make it two in a row. Not quite. And that's 36 through three for Tim. Mike Morgan waiting to fill his spare. He would like to put another mark up each time, at least put up one out of two. And boy, has he had this shot for a while? The 1, 8, and 9. It's 3 or 4 times in this match he's been looking at that leave. Well, he's thrown two balls. He's hit both object pins. The head pin the first time, this time he shot at the three pin, took that out, but he's still looking at six pins, one ball remaining. Needs an out here, doesn't want a bad frame, and he gets it. Beautifully done. Gonna remember that one. Was able to scramble for a nine box. Two open frames, though, for Mike Morgan to work on. Almost was left with a 5-7, but he got the break with the five pin going down, something that Tim wasn't able to do. Two in a row, lead now 11 plus this ball. More to that lead, now 20. Oh. Fair in the fourth. Take a quick look. 57 of the ball for Mike Morgan, 45 for Tim Lipke. See if Timmy can make another run at Mike Morgan. Don't go away.
Hi, I've been telling you that at Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan in Salem, New Hampshire, you will find the best price from a dealership that cares. Well, let me tell you what you will find when you get there. First, when we can display Toyota, Dodge, and Nissan at one location, this is a rare opportunity for you to view the best selection of cars, trucks, and minivans in New England. Second, we are constantly adding cars and trucks to our used car inventory. So if it's a new or used car or truck, just remember Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan in Salem, New Hampshire.
Hi, honey.
Hey, how's your checkup?
Fine.
Really?
Yeah, heart's good.
And your cholesterol?
Good. You know, the doctor said the healthy diet is paying off.
See? You better keep eating those Cheerios.
As part of a heart-healthy diet, the FDA says soluble fiber from whole grain oat foods like Cheerios may reduce the risk of heart disease. Cheerios is the only leading ready-to-eat cereal that meets this FDA standard.
I always knew you had a good heart.
You did?
Mm-hmm. That's why I married you.
I thought you married me because I was good-looking.
The one and only Cheerios.
Honey, out Cheerios, and they're all for me.
Nobody can say no to Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios.
With real golden honey and toasty crunchy O's, they're absolutely irresistible.
Nobody can say no to the Honey Nut O's in Honey Nut Cheerios. No, no, you can't say no to Honey Nut Cheerios.
Everybody loves it.
Okay, two victories in a row. Timmy's fighting hard to make it three, but he finds himself down by 21, plus the ball that Mike Morgan is going to throw. .853 at the turn, this final game. Much-needed clutch mark by Tim Lipke, the four horsemen to the left. Just splits the one and the two, and usually you'll leave that corner pin standing. Not this time. An extremely important mark in the six for Tim after going three open frames. Now Mike Morgan working on a spare. This time he does leave the 5-7 and also the 8. Try to split the 5 and the 8, so you can cut the 5 into the 7. Nope. Can gain two more in count by knocking this one down. Lead now 30. Tim has a mark in the 6th already. The 3, the 8, and the 10. Well, he'll be open in the 6th. Chance for Timmy to cut into that lead. Stands at 30. Make it 29. That was a 9 box. Ball slid into the channel, caught the wood before it hit the 10 pin. Well, you see it. Four boxes remaining, down by 29. Can cut it to 19 with a strike. Not a strike, but let's cut it to 22. 3-6, and the 8 pins. Oh, yes. Nicely done. Two in a row. Goes straight at it, pushes the 3 pin into the 8. Oh, boy. Well, he wanted to hit the head pin. That's the first objective. Second one was not to hit it full, and he drove it right straight through, missing by inches. The 1, the 5, and the 8 are out of there. And it's 91 through 8. Timmy would need some help from Mike Morgan. Leading by 22, he's opposite a spare 3 and then an 8 frame. So 21 pins in these two frames by Tim Lipke. That's going to help the cause. Take a look at that one in the 1-3 pocket. 8 pin and the 10 pin. Okay, Mike Morgan on lane 31. Might have heard his brother in the background. Throw another one. Let's think about 1,350 different things. Meaning that triple strike pool. Oh, hang on. Thought it was coming back. One in the 3. Spare up in the 9, in the 8th. Lead now 31. Strike by Tim, keeps his hopes alive. Take a look, 1-2 pocket, and they all go. Well, I think to have a shot at this match, you probably win the triple strike pool at the same time. Oh, it's good enough for a double. Triangle. 4, 7, and 8. Spare on strike. And a 128 and a 371 for Tim Lipke. Mike Morgan already at 365. Strike in the 9th. That triple strike pool is still alive. He just touches the head pin here, but gets good mixing action, and finally this 8 pin and then the 7. That was light. Now, sometimes you turn around and bury one in the 1-3 or the 1-2 pocket and get the double. Let's see what happens. Like I said, there's two. Here we go, folks. $1,350. A lot of times you get one strike you don't expect by hitting the head pin light as he did in the 9th frame. You come right back and bury one in the pocket and get a legitimate one, and that's what he's done. He's finished with three strikes. Unfortunately, they're not consecutive. This is the big one. $1,350 riding on this ball. Through the middle. Great try. Great round of applause for Mike Morgan, who will go on to meet Gary Carrington next week. We'll add the scores up, a 166-418 for a triple. We'll take a short break, come back and talk to the bowlers.
It's good.
And your cholesterol?
Good.
You know, the doctor said the healthy diet is paying off.
See? You better keep eating those Cheerios.
As part of a heart-healthy diet, the FDA says soluble fiber from whole grain oat foods like Cheerios may reduce the risk of heart disease. Cheerios is the only leading ready-to-eat cereal that meets this FDA standard.
I always knew you had a good heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I married you.
I thought you married me because I was good-looking.
The one and only Cheerios.
Everyone at Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan in Salem, New Hampshire is very proud and excited to again be a major sponsor of Stars and Strikes. We feel that over the years, you, the bowling enthusiast, have become a very important part of our family at Rockingham. And as such, I promise that we will live up to our pledge that we will provide you the best service you have ever experienced. And if you're purchasing a new or used vehicle, at Rockingham, we pledge that we will beat any bona fide deal on any Toyota, any Dodge, or any Nissan anywhere in New England. So just remember, Rockingham, Toyota, Dodge, Nissan on Route 97 in Salem, New Hampshire.
Hi, honey.
Hey, how's your checkup?
Fine.
Really?
Yeah, heart's good.
And your cholesterol?
Good. You know, the doctor said the healthy diet is paying off.
See? You better keep eating those Cheerios.
As part of a heart-healthy diet, the FDA says soluble fiber from whole grain oat foods like Cheerios may reduce the risk of heart disease. Cheerios is the only leading ready-to-eat cereal that meets this FDA standard.
I always knew you had a good heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I married you.
I thought you married me because I was good-looking.
The one and only Cheerios.
Okay, I'm here with Tim. There's a check for $250, Tim. Try to make it three in a row. Tough sledding today, though, against this guy.
Well, against somebody of the caliber of Mike, you can't let up at all. And he just came on. I was fortunate enough to come on a little bit at the end of each game. I love the last two boxes, evidently, but my spirit feels hurt, and I just couldn't put anything together. Credit goes to Mike.
Nice going.
Thank you.
Okay, Tim. Okay, now the bonus ball, $80 riding on it. Let's see if last time Mike was here, he was able to knock it off. I don't have a monitor to look at, but it didn't sound very well. Let's go here. George Jones from Quincy, Mass. His guess was 10. Mike, we haven't got much time here. Next week, Gary Carrington, another easy match, huh?
Are you crazy? He's one of the best ones out there. Hats off to Tim. He bowled with the flow and gave me everything he had. Luckily, I had a little more.
Okay. From Mike and I, for Doug Brown, the entire crew, championship of the week next week. Come back Saturday at noontime.